Hello friends, welcome back. In today's video, we'll be looking into the various bitwise operators in Java. So the bitwise operators are the negation, which is called as the complement, which is a unary bitwise operator. And then you have the binary operator, which is AND operator. So this is a bitwise AND operation. And then this is a pipe, which is called as a bitwise OR operation. And then you have the caret symbol, which is for exclusive OR operation. And then we also do have the shift operations. So this is the right shift, okay? And then we have the left shift operation. So this is the left shift operation. And then we have the right shift zero fill operator like this. Okay, so this is right shift zero fill. And we know like how this AND is evaluated. So if the bit values are like 0, 0 and 0, 1. And since I said like all these operators from here till here are the binary operators. So you require two operands to perform the operation. So 1, 0 and 1, 1. So if it is AND, like for 0, 0, it will be 0, 1, 0 and 0, 1, it will be 0. And if both are 1s only, then you will be having the 1. For OR, what will happen is, so this is for the AND operation. And for the OR operation, so 0, 0 will be 0. If any 1 is there, then so the output will be 1. And coming to exclusive OR, so exclusive OR, like 0, 0 will be 0 and 1, 1 also will be 0. If any 1 is there, 1, 1 is there, then the output will be 1. So this is exclusive OR. So this is operand 1. So you can say like OP1 and this is OP2. And these are the consecutive outputs that you will be getting for these two kinds of bits from two different operands. Okay, so say for example, if I just wanted to use this complement, if I give 1 and then if I say x is equal to 1 and then I say a negation of x, then I'll be getting the complement. All the bits will be flipped. Okay, so 0 bit will become 1 and 1 bit will become 0. Okay, so this is how the bitwise operators basic concept is. So I'll show you programs, I'll show you how to use bitwise operators in the program. Okay, so this is my basic skeleton of my Java program. So public class main, and the name of the file is main.java, and this is the main method. So inside the main method, I'll be giving the instructions. So I'll be taking int. So first I'll show you the complement or the negation operation. So I have taken x is equal to 1. Okay. So now I'll be doing the complement of it. So I'll say system.out.println. Here in, for our understanding sake, I'll say complement x. Okay. And then here I say negation of x. Okay. So this is the operation that we want to perform. And we'll see what will be the output. Okay, so let me execute this and show you. So I have executed it and we got like the complement is -2. Okay, so maybe this is not quite understood by us. So what I'll do is, I'll take the input also in the binary format. So how can you give a binary literal? So I just have to give 0b. When I gave 0b, then whatever I give here will be considered to be binary. Okay, so this is a binary literal, so I have given 0b. So let me again show you what will be the output. Okay, so you got -2. Now the point is, so this output also, like this negation of x also, I want it in the binary format. For that I have one method which will actually convert this negation x into binary, which is integer dot. Okay, so I can convert this integer because this -2 over here that we are seeing. So this -2 over here that we are seeing is in integer data type. So we don't want this to be an integer data type. So what I'm doing is I'm actually making it again get converted to binary string. Okay. So I have a method which is called as to binary string. And this method will be taking an argument. So what is the argument that we want to take? We want to take the tilde. Okay, so negation symbol, this is the symbol. This is called as the tilde symbol. Okay, so which is used to represent the negation. So I said negation of x. Okay, so now I'll be getting a binary. This here in I'll be getting the integer. Okay, so the decimal integer value in decimal format. But here in I'll be getting it in binary format. Okay, so that it will be easy for you. So input also I have taken a binary literal. Okay, so I have taken a binary literal over here. Okay, right. So let us see. Okay, so it's a bitwise manipulation. So even if, so you can see here, since integer is 32 bits, so you can see 32 bits here and the negation of 32 zeros. Okay, so imagine this to be like what we have given 0B1, right? Meaning 32, 31 zeros like this. And finally, there is a one. Okay, so this is what is this X representation initially. Now, what happened, as I said, like tilde of X means complement. So what happens is this bit will become zero and the rest of all 31 bits will become one. Okay. So that's what we have got the representation over here. So this is what has happened. Okay. And why did we get minus two is that this representation is nothing but minus two in decimal. When you convert this x is equal to 31 ones and a zero, when you convert it into decimal, you'll be getting a minus two. Okay. So negation of one. Okay. So negation of one is nothing but minus two. And I showed it in binary format. Okay. So this is what is called as complement bitwise operator. So now let me show you the other operations, which is an AND operation. So to do the AND operation, so let me take two literals. So initially I'm taking 8. Okay. So then you take y is equal to, so anything like I'm taking 12. Okay. So now I want the operation AND operation between X and Y. So I'll say AND Y. Okay. So X and Y. So again, I want to represent it in binary format. So I'm saying X and Y. So this is, so wherein I'm saying X, the symbol is AND symbol. So which is X and Y like this. So I'm representing it. So let me put it in brackets. Okay. So here also I want to convert it. So I'm passing this, which is X and Y. Okay. So X and Y. So let me show you the output. So this is an AND operation. So AND and Y is 8 and then X and Y in the binary format. Okay. So how do you represent 8? 8 you represent as 1000, right? So this is the binary representation. So let me solve this and tell you. So how X is represented in binary. So this is bitwise, right? So 8 will be converted to the bit format. So which is 1000. So this is 8 and this is 4, 2 and 1. So these are the representations. And so we want 12, right? So this is 8 and then 4. So like this. So this is 12. Okay, so now we are performing AND operation between these two. So as I already gave you the truth table, so 0 and 0 will evaluate to be 0, 0, 0 will evaluate to 0, and 0, 1 also will evaluate to 0. Okay, 1 and 1 will give you a 1. Okay, so what is this representation? So this representation is nothing but an 8. So I got an 8 in decimal as well as I got 1000, which is represented in the binary format. Okay, so this is the AND operation. So now let me show you the OR operation. So to do the OR operation, okay, so I just need to change the symbol. So I'll be changing the symbol to OR over here. and let us see what will be the output of it. Let us see the output. So this is the OR operation. So what is x? X is equal to 8, right? So which is represented in bits like this, 1000, and 12 is represented as 1100. And now we are trying to perform the OR operation. So 0 and 0 will give us 0, and 0 and 0 will give us 0, and 0, 1 will give 1, and 1 and 1 will give 1. Okay, so what is it in decimal? So this, when you convert it into binary to decimal, it will be 12. In binary, it is 1100. So you can see that output over here. So this is regarding the OR operation. So let us now look into the next operation, which is the exclusive OR operation. So I'll just take the caret symbol. So exclusive OR. So this is exclusive OR, which will be there on top of numerical number 6 on the keyboard. Okay, so this is exclusive OR operation. So let me execute. So this is the answer I got. So let me again show you this operation. So x is nothing but 1000, which is 8, and then y is 1100, and then now we are performing the exclusive OR operation. So for 0 and 0, it will be 0, and for 0 and 0, it will be 0, and 0 and 1, it will be 1, 1 and 1, it will be 0. Okay, so what is this number in decimal? It is 4, right? So 100. So you can see that over here. So I got 4 and 00. So you can also represent them in terms of binary literals, like how I have done in the previous case. Like 8 I have represented as 0B1000. So I can also do it in such manner. Okay, so I can say 0, so 0B and then 1100. So I can also represent it in this manner. You'll get the same answer. Okay, so I got 4 and 100, which is in the binary format. Okay, so this is regarding the AND, OR, and exclusive OR operation. Now I'll show you the shift operations. Okay, so to do the shift operation, so you can take any one number. So I'll be taking the 8 number. Okay, so let me take 8. So I'll say x left shift. Okay, so here I need to mention the shifts. Okay, so how much I want to shift. Say for example, I want to shift onto the left, right? So it is left shift, and I want to shift to 1. So here you just need to understand. Okay, I'll tell you after showing the output. So let me do the left shift. Okay, so and what is the shift? Okay, so the shift is 1. Okay, so I want to shift 8 onto the left. Okay, so let me show you the operation. Okay, so 16. Let me explain you this. Okay, so what happened is this is 2 power 0, and which is 2 power 1 and 2 power 2 and 2 power 3 and 2 power 4. So which is represented like this, right? Okay, and 2 power 5 and so on. Okay, so in binary, the numbers are represented like this. Okay, so this will be 1. 2 and then 4, and this is 8, and then this is 16, and this is 32, and so on. Okay, 64 and so on. So 8 is nothing but this bit will be 1 and the rest of the bits will be 0. Now what I did is, so the bits are like this, and I want to shift this onto the left, meaning that I want to shift this one bit to my left. So what will happen is it will be 1. And what will be filled here is this side, because these 3 bits will come and take these positions. And here there won't be any bit, right? So this will be 0. Okay, so it will fill this position with the 0, the left shift. Okay, so the new 0 will be added over here. And the shift happened. And you can see that it is multiplied by 2. Okay, so 8 into 2, so 16. Okay, so if you are shifting onto the left, it becomes multiplication. Okay, so that's what I got, 8 shifted, so I got 16. So this is in decimal format. And this shift operation over here, I didn't change it in the println statement, but you understood, right? Okay, so which is x left shift 1. so which has become 16. So this is 16 is represented like this, 1 and 4 zeros. So this is the binary representation. So let me show you what will happen if I shift 2 times. Okay, so you can change it here. It is an integer, so you can change it however you want. So whatever number you want, you can place it there. Okay, so this is a left shift operation, and let me also change 2 over here. So I want to shift 2. So now what will happen when I want to shift 2 positions? So this is the first position wherein it will come to 16, and in the next position it will come to 32. So let me execute this and show you. Okay, right. So you can see I got 32. Okay, so this is what is called as left shift operation. You can also take the binary literal over here, whatever format you want, you can take it. Okay, right. Now let me show you the next operation. So what is the next operation? Right shift. Okay, so I'll do the same operation. I'll take the same number and do the right shift. Okay, so what will happen when I do the right shift? When I do the right shift, the reverse of the left shift is nothing but the right shift. So let me also change here. So the operator is this 2 greater than symbols. So this is right shift. Okay, so since I said like it is a binary operation, it needs 2 operands. Okay, so one is the variable number that you want to shift, and this is the count. Okay, so how many shifts you want to do. So let me execute this and show you. Okay, so you can see it became 2 and 10, wherein the right shift operation will divide it. Okay, so this is x, right? 1000 is x. Now what happened is I want to shift it onto the right. So what will happen? So since this is an integer, there will be 32 bits like this. It's a positive number. So all these are zeros, right? So now what will happen is, so this is at 2 power 0, like 8th position. So this is 4, this is 2 and 1. So this is at this particular position, this bit. Okay, so 8, right? So this is like this. The bit positions are like this. And now I want to shift it onto the right. So what happens is it is like division by 2. Okay, so when I divide 8 by 2, I'll get 4, right? So this is one shift, but here I have done 2 shifts, right? So this is one shift, and from here to here, it is another shift, which is like 2 shifts. So that's the reason why I got 2, and how 2 is represented in binary, it is represented as 10. Okay, so that's a binary representation, and this is the decimal representation. So this is the right shift operation. Okay. Now let me show you right shift zero fill operation. So right shift zero fill operation is represented as 3 greater than symbols like this. Now what will happen is the bits that will add up over here. So if it is, for example, a negative number, what happens is it will fill 1. If it is a right shift, what happens is if it is a negative number. Okay, so say for example, it's a negative number. Let me show that. Okay. Let me take minus 2. Okay. So minus 2. And now I'm doing a right shift. Okay. So I'm doing a right shift. So take a look at this. Okay. So you can see that I have done a right shift. And after doing the right shift, since this is a signed number, minus 2, when I did a right shift, what happened is I got minus 1 only, and there are 32 bits over here. Just take a look at this particular bit pattern here. So there are 32 bits over here, and so the bits are shifted, right? So what happened, the bit at this particular rightmost position is lost. Okay, so the bit at this particular rightmost position is lost. Okay, 2 bits are lost. Let me show you that also. Let me show you the minus x. Okay, so I'll show you what is x. I'll simply show you x so that you'll understand. Okay, right. So let me execute this program. Yes. Okay, so this is minus 2 representation.
Okay, so x is like this. Okay, so what is this? This is minus 2. Okay, now what I did is, you can see there is a 0 over here at this particular last position. Now what I did is, I have shifted it onto the right. Okay, so I shifted onto the right. So this 0 will be lost. Okay, so this 0 will be lost. Now what it will fill is, it will fill with what is there over here. So at the most significant bit, there is a 1. So what it will do is, even if it is right shift, it will fill with what is there in the most significant bit. So at the most significant bit, there is 1. So what it will do is, it will fill with it. So after 1 right shift, what will happen is, this 0 will be lost and 1 is filled. And again, 2 shifts I have done. So it has taken 2 ones and it has added over here. Okay. So this side, this 0, 1 is lost and 2 ones are added over here. So this is right shift ending. So that is why I got minus 1. Okay. So whatever is there in the most significant bit, that will be added. So what is the purpose of the right shift 0 fill is that, in the previous case, what happened is, like, whatever is there in the most significant bit, that is replaced for the lost bits, okay, in the right shift operation. But in the right shift 0 fill, as the name suggests, it will be filling with the zeros irrespective of the sign. So if you apply this right shift 0 fill on a positive number, so if you are applying it on a positive number, it will be similar to doing a right shift operation. If you are applying this on a negative number, so then what will happen is, the most significant bit in the negative number will be 1, right? So now it will fill this numbers with the 0. Okay, so that is the difference between right shift and right shift 0 fill operation. So if you just apply it on the positive number, then it will just act like a right shift operation. But this is advantageous only when you want to apply, make a negative number into a positive number. So that's what I have done. So let me actually show once again, like, the right shift operation on a negative number. So let me actually execute this and show you. So this is the negative number. So I have taken a negative number which is minus 2. And when I have executed it, like, I got, after right shifting, I got minus 1. Okay. So I got a negative number. When I right shifted, again, I got a negative number because it is replacing it with the 1s. Okay. So now let me actually execute this right shift operation. Okay. 0 fill operation. So I have done a right shift 0 operation. Okay, so now let me show you the answer. So you'll be getting a positive number. So when I executed it, so you can see that it has filled this shifts with the zeros. So I got a positive number. Okay, so that's the difference between right shift and right shift 0 fills. Okay, right. So if it is a positive number, it will just act like a right shift operation. Say, for example, I'm taking 2. Okay, so it's a positive number. So even if I apply right shift 0 fill, it will not have any difference, but the difference will be seen. Okay, so it is like 0. Okay, what is this? Okay, so it is 1000 at all, like, right? So this is x actually initially. So when I did the right shift operation, what happened? It came for the first shift, it came here. And what is filled here? So zeros are filled here because at the most significant bit, at MSB, you're having a 0. So 0 is filled. Okay, if there is a 1, 1 is filled. Okay, so this is regarding the right shift operation. Now coming to the right shift 0 fill, I'm repeating it again for you. So if it is positive number, then it will act. Even if you apply right shift 0 fill, it will be similar to right shift operation. If it is a negative number, then it becomes positive number. Okay, so that's what we have seen over here. So I give a negative number and I'm doing right shift 0 fill. And when I execute it, I'm getting a positive number. So you can see that this is a positive number. Because I got a positive number, because the most significant bit has become 0. Okay, I got a positive number because the most significant bit has become 0. Okay, so these are all the bitwise operators. Hope this video is helpful to you. Thank you for watching.